like, this is the human genome. Do they just go for the most common SNP? Like, if you're like mapping back to the human genome, say, do they just choose the most common one to use?
I think the original Human Genome Project, they took 9 people, and they just shared their DNA out. They amplified, they shared, and depending on whoever got whatever piece. And so some of the locations, they know exactly what it is, and some other locations, it's just not so clear. And now with the 1,000 Genome Project, they sequence, you know, 5 different ethnic, you know, racial groups. And so it's much better known. And so when you sequence, they know, well, actually, I don't know when you map the, say, RNA-seq or ChIP-seq, I think it's mapping to that reference genome, which, you know, maybe for that piece happened to be an African-American, and that piece is like Asian, that piece is a Caucasian, it's possible. But right now, for each individual, I mean, I would imagine a good read mapper would need to know to map this to the Caucasian genome, to the African genome, to the Asian genome, right? Which will be quite different. Good thing is, most of the SNP frequency is usually not like within 100 base pair. You probably don't have so many SNPs that are linked. Therefore, each read, you know, most of the current read mappers, they say within the first 50 base pair or 38 base pair, you allow 2 mismatches, which usually if you have a SNP, it will still be able to find the right place. Okay. Other questions? All right, and so next lecture, we'll tell you how to use epigenetics. Understand what's happening.